let's begin first with a positive news, and that is that at least there seems to be a relief in terms of no new confirmation of COVID-19 cases on Sunday. So that does come as a temporary relief. In terms of red zones, it still remains the same, Omar. We have Kottayam as well as Kannur. But there has been a change with respect to green zones. Wayanad was a green zone and now has become an orange zone. And two other zones which were in the orange, that is Alappuzha as well as Thrissur, have been made into green zones. Rest, of course, remain orange. Now, I am coming to you from an orange zone. Here, it means marketplaces should be functioning as normal. It's been permitted. But on the ground, let me show you, that's really not the scene. While there are some shops which are open, a lot of places, vendors have actually not turned up. So there's a very cautious approach. Business is not as normal as usual. This is also a place where vegetables and fish and everything is sold, and it's supposed to be extremely crowded during this time of the day. But you can see it's a very less turnout. So this gives you a sense of what's really happening on the ground, the economics of it. Business is certainly not as usual. Even though shops can be open, people are still being extremely cautious. A quick run-up with what exactly is allowed and not allowed. Public transport in no zone is allowed in Kerala. Beauty parlors, barber shops, even liquor shops will remain closed. Barbers have been given permission to go home and offer their services with adequate safety measures. Restaurants will be open, but only for takeaways. Shops will be open between 7 and 5 p.m. in orange zones, but can remain open till 7 p.m., a little extended time in the green zone. So there are certain changes. Government offices and private offices with 33% and 55% staff can function, but on the ground, a lot of cautiousness, Omar.